Hey there, I'm Chris from Intro Games with a quick look at Underwater Basket Weaving The Game. It's a gateway mass market game for 2 to 6 players, takes 15 to 30 minutes to play, and is for players 8 and up. It's not just a joke. Together with some friends, you've decided to try your hand at, yes, weaving baskets underwater. Working together, you'll roll dice to match cards and form a basket. There are 3 difficulty levels and 3 different ways to play: cooperative, semi-co-op, and competitive modes. That gives you 9 different ways to play this small box game. In whatever mode you're playing, in whatever difficulty you're playing, your goal is to complete your basket. And you're going to complete your basket by rolling dice and assigning them to complete cards. And in the cooperative version, if everyone has completed their baskets before the deck runs out, everyone wins. The deck is also the timer of the game, and the deck number of cards is set based on the number of players, so fewer players means there are fewer cards in the deck. So in this 4-player setup here, everyone starts with a basket card, 3 dice of the same color, and a few cards. In a cooperative version, these are open information, but in the semi-co-op or the competitive version, these cards would be held in your hand. Your goal is to finish your basket with weave before your deck runs out, and to do that you'll be matching dice to cards. Each round starts by rolling your dice and then looking around at other players to see what they rolled and what they need. The main phase of each round is where players simultaneously try to trade their dice or cards with other players to get the matches they want. Whenever you trade, you're always trading one die for one die or one card for one card. Bear in mind that every trade costs 1 card from the deck, and the game ends when the deck runs out, so you'll want to trade efficiently. Whenever you're done trading, assign the dice, place the cards in your basket, and draw another card to end the round. So just as an example, if I'm playing the orange player here, to put this card into my basket, I just need a 4 of any color of dice. If I had 2 dice of the same color that equal 5 or less, I could put this card in. And for this one, I need 3 different dice of 3 different colors that have all the same numbers. This is a harder one to do, but it's worth more points in the competitive version, and it's also worth 3 squares of weave. So I have a choice to make. Obviously, I can trade my dice away or my cards away to help other players. I can also choose to assign the dice to the cards that I want to complete. So I could use this die and this die to complete this card and put it in my basket. And putting it in my basket just means covering up the kind of shaded squares in the basket with the real squares. As I add more stuff, I'm going to be overlapping cards like such. The idea being that my basket's going to be exactly 4 layers tall and exactly 3 layers wide. Once I've done that, I can begin working on the handle. So if this looks like you're kind of assembling a little puzzle here, that's totally intentional. There's plenty of ways to make this work, but it does add a little wrinkle that makes you plan ahead a little bit. Once your basket is done, you're going to want to assemble the handle, which is accomplished by completing any 2 cards during the same round. Once you've completed them, flip them over to show the handle, and you're done. Just because you're done doesn't mean you're stopping playing. You'll still be rolling dice and trading resources, but your focus can now shift to helping other players. So this is the part where I mentioned that you're doing this underwater. After all, this is underwater basket weaving. On the pool level, basically the tutorial level for first-time players, talking is fine, speak freely. On the kind of standard and hard levels, lake and ocean, there's no talking allowed. On the lake difficulty, there's a little bit of talking allowed between the end of one round and the start of the next, but on ocean slash hard difficulty, no talking is allowed at all times. Hand gestures and hand signals are fine, and this just means that you're trying to communicate and get each other's attention to trade the things you want to trade. Co-op mode is pure cooperation. Again, everyone wins if everyone's baskets are complete before the deck runs out. Semi-co-op mode introduces the points values on the card. Everyone loses if the baskets aren't done, but only the player with the most points wins. Competitive mode gets feisty since alliances can be formed or broken, and the luck of the dice can change your strategy at every turn. On any of these modes, you always have to kind of balance making the thing you want to make versus trading it away and helping someone else. So, for example, if red's trying to complete this 4 or less card and they need two dice of the same color that equal 4 or less, they could talk to orange and be like, hey orange, I'll trade you two of my dice for your two ones. And I have to think, well, I also have a card kind of like that, and if I trade both of my ones away, I won't be able to fill this card myself. So I kind of have to balance these two things together. Will you make the right trades, or will time run out? This has been Underwater Basket Weaving, and I've been Chris Backe of Entro Games. Thanks for watching.